went to work with the page number 20 of the module. Vamos a trabajar con la página del módulo. But before we start class, we went to make a small review of action verb, the class before. Vamos a hacer un pequeño repaso de lo que vimos la clase anterior. Okay, review the action verb. Remember, the action verb express something that person, animal, or object can do. Acá acuérdense que nosotros vimos lo que era la acción del verbo. We make sentences, we find the verbs, we underline verb in the sentences. Encontramos lo que son los verbos, la acción en la oración. Example, we have he hacks for him. We know that the action verb is acts. The supermarket closed soon. We know that the action verb is close. They clean the park. We know that the action verb is clean. You draw the human being. Sabemos que draw is the action verb. She opened the book. We know that the action verb is open. The baby cried. We know that the verb is, the action verb is cry. She called her mother, and the action verb is called. Remember that we give this class last week. Nosotros dimos esta clase la semana pasada. So, I'm giving you a small review. Le estoy dando un pequeño repaso de lo que nosotros dimos la clase pasada. Okay, the new class today is the simple past tense. Here we have the rule of the simple past tense. We have the rule with the irregular verbs. We have the ending I, we have D. Todo verbo que termina en E le agregamos D. Like example, we have live, lived, stare, stared. Okay, here we make the apply the rule of the simple past tense. En la primera lo que hicimos fue aplicarle la regla del simple past. We have ending vowel plus while, we have yet. Si termina en Y, ¿verdad? Le agregamos ed. In this part, like stay and play, we have only ed. Le agregamos ed. Why? Because if the word starts with a vowel and a consonant, we cannot apply the rule of yet. Si la palabra empieza con una vocal y un consonante, no podemos hacer, como vamos a explicarle la segunda parte, como try and carry, because when the word starts with a vowel, cuando la palabra empieza con una vocal, no podemos cambiarlo a ied, como está aquí abajo. ¿Estamos claro aquí? You have to know this rule. If the word starts with a vowel, si empieza con una vocal, and one consonant, we cannot change it like this part. We have ending in consonant Y. We change Y to I, and we have ED. Ejemplo aquí, ¿verdad? We have tried, tried. We have carry, carried. Aquí sí pudimos transformar, cambiarla. La I, como usted le dice, en Y, a I latina. Agregamos ED in this part. In this part, we cannot change because the word starts with a vowel, one vowel and one consonant. Cuando empieza con una vocal y un consonante, no se le puede aplicar como aplicamos aquí, like try and carry. We have the next rule, one syllable, single vowel, and ending in single consonant with double D, final consonant. And we have ED. Ejemplo, tenemos aquí not and rip. Tenemos una vocal y un consonante. When it have only one consonant and one vowel and one consonant, we double the consonant. Cuando hay una vocal y un consonante, como not, like O and D, doblamos el consonante, que es la D. Not did. And we had the rule of the simple past, ED. Agregamos aquí lo que es ED. The same with rip. the consonant committed. Aquí doblamos la T porque aquí hay una vocal y un consonante. Here is the same, prefer, prefer it, with double the consonant R. Okay, here we have one vowel and one consonant, and with double D, the consonant, and we apply the rules ED. Aquí lo que hicimos fue, cuando termina con una vocal y un consonante, doblamos el consonante más agregándole ED. We have some simple sentences. We have it affirmative, we have it negative, interrogative sentences, and short answer. Okay, in the first part, we have past simple tense. Affirmative sentences en la forma afirmativa, both in past. Lo tenemos en la forma afirmativa, pero lo tenemos en pasado. We have I or he walk in the park. Here we have the rule. Aplicamos la regla de walk, adding ed, agregando ed. So we have he walked in the park, or can be he walked in the park. Puede ser cualquiera de las dos. We have the second one. We have I went or he went to the park. Aquí hay unos verbos irregulares las cuales ustedes el pasado no se le aplica lo que es la regla de ed. We change it. Example, go. We change it. Went. In the negative form, in past, we have I did not walk in the park. Or he did not walk in the park. I or he did not go to the park. Here we have did. Did, we use it in the past form. Interrogative sentences. Did you? Here we have did you walk in the park? Or can be did he walk in the park? Did you go to the park? Or did he go to the park? We have these sentences. We have interrogative form, we have negative form, and we have affirmative form, but in the past simple tense. We have short answer, yes, I, no, I. We have yes, I did, walk, or he, yes, he did walk or go, or no, he did not walk or go. Or can be, I did not walk or go, depending on the word we want to use here. We have irregular verbs. We have at least irregular verbs applying the rules of the simple present. We have infinitive. We have visit. We are applying the simple past. We have ed, so we use visited. We have love, the word ending in. E, we have only D, love it. We have enjoy, enjoy it. We have ED. Study, we have study here. We change the Y and we put studied. We have stop, we have one vowel and one consonant. We double the consonant and we put ED, stop it. Aquí teníamos una vocal y un consonante. Y lo que hicimos fue doblar el consonante más ED, la regla del simple past. Then we have the double the consonant plus ED. Aquí también tenemos una vocal y un consonante. We double here the consonant, el consonante que es la T, y agregamos aquí ED. We have two syllables, we stress on second syllable and end it with a single consonant. We double the consonant plus ED. We have permit. We have one vowel and one consonant, and we have permitted. We double the consonant, that is T, la T que doblamos, and we have the rule of the simple past, ED. Agregamos lo que es la regla del simple pasado, ED. We have double the consonant plus ED. Aquí lo que vamos a hacer es doblar los consonantes. Commit, committed. Aquí doble el consonante, en la final, como es la I, la T, ¿verdad? We double the T, and we have ED. Aquí aplicamos las reglas de acuerdo a la finalización de los verbos. Besides here, we have most verb form past tense by having ed. Aquí hay más palabras, ¿verdad?, que podemos agregar en las reglas en el simple past agregando ed. We have here a list of present, and we have a list of applying the ruling past. Walk, walked. Answer, answered. Borrow, borrowed. Listen, listened. Play, played. Jerry changed the present tense to the past tense. I changed one in this part in present, and here I apply the rule in past. We have verb with a short vowel ending in a consonant form, the past tense by doubling the consonant before adding ed. Aquí tenemos palabras que terminan con una vocal y un consonante. We have words that only start with a vowel and a consonant. What happened here? When it starts with a vowel and a consonant, we double the consonant. Cuando hay una vocal y un consonante, doblamos el consonante. If you can see here, we have pat, patted, we double the T. Doblamos la D, and we have ED in the rule of the past tense. Y agregamos la regla del simple present. We have fit, fit, fitted. Aquí agregamos la regla del simple past, doblando el consonante más agregando ed. We have stop, ¿verdad? We have here one vowel and one consonant, and here we double the consonant, stop it. Doblamos aquí lo que es la P y agregamos las reglas de ed. We have pet, we have one vowel and a consonant, and we put pet it. We double the T and we have ed. And we have here the last one that says step. And we double the P and we had ED. Verb that end in form the past tense by adding D. Ahora vamos con las palabras que terminan E, la cual solamente se aplica en la D. Tenemos hop, hopped. We apply the rule in past, adding D. Announce, announce it. We had the D, because it's ending in E. We have bounce, and here we apply the rule, bounce it. We apply the D because the word ended in E. Race, race it. Share, share it. Here we apply the rule in past. Now we have bear that ending in form the past tense by changing the while into adding D. Example, we have hurry, the ending in while. Tenemos hurry, que quiere decir apurarse, que termina en Y. We change it, lo cambiamos, and we put it, hurry it. Aquí lo aplicamos la regla I, ¿verdad? Le pusimos ied. We have worry, worry, ending in while, and we change it in the past, worry it. We have cry, ending in while, and we change it in past, cry. We have copy, and the past tense, we have copied in the past. And we have rely, ending in while, and here we change it, rely it. To make you can apply these rules, you need to know with what word ending we use each rule of the past tense. Para que ustedes puedan aplicar estas reglas, ustedes tienen que saber con qué terminación de cada verbo regular se le agrega, ya sea D, ED, O, y ED. The way I explained in this part, remember, if the word ending in one consonant, we have ED. If it ends in E, si termina E, we only add D. The same here, enjoy. We had ED, enjoy. We have study. We change the wine, cambiamos la Y, and we put study. We have stop. When the word start with a vowel and a consonant, we double the consonant, doblamos el consonante, and we put stop it. The same here, so with bat, we have batted. We double one vowel and one consonant, we double the T, and we have ED. And here, the word permit and commit that at the end of the word, we have one vowel and one consonant. We double the consonant, permitted, and we have commit, we have committed. We had the two T. Okay, we have here the interrogative and short answer. Okay, did is the past of do. Interrogative, short answer. In the interrogative form, we put did in the front of the subject. After the subject, we use the infinitive. For short answer, we use did or did not. See here, we have did in the two ways. We have it in affirmative past, and we have it in negative past. We have example with sentences. This is question form to make questions. Did you buy the book? Did you buy the book? This is the affirmative form. If we want to answer in short answer, we use yes, I did, or no, I did not. This is the short answer. Did the children study? This is the affirmative way. And in short answer, we have yes, they did, or no, they did not. So we use did and did not in the simple past, in the past tense. Now, we have a next topic that is there is and there are. A moment. Pero yo no, que hay compañeros que quieren entrar. Un problema cuando yo estoy explicando. I cannot. Mommy, can you listen to me? ¿Me pueden escuchar?
Yes.
Okay, I probably yes, you can listen to me. Okay, wait a moment. I have a problem with the computer that I want to hoping. Si me salgo, por cualquier eventualidad, me esperan, ¿sí? Because I have a problem with the internet today. Wait a moment. I'm trying to. Me congelo aquí. Cannot open here. So I want to go in, I'm going to come out, and I'm going to go in back. Voy a salir y entrar nuevamente, okay? I'm here with the computer.
Okay.
Because here we have problem that it cannot open. No quiere abrirla. Se congeló. Okay, I'm going to come in and I'm going to continue. Okay. Let me see if you can see the PowerPoint. Can you see?
Sure.
No. Okay. We're going to continue with the page of the model. We're going to continue with the page of the model. Okay. In the page 22, we have the question form of there is and there are. If you see the practice, we have the question form. We have, is there a dog in the supermarket? Are there any dog in the supermarket? Is there a security guard in the shop? Okay, we have it there in the singular way and we have it in the plural way. We have it in the two forms. Lo tenemos en las dos formas. So to make you can apply are, para que puedan aplicar eso, you need to know, we use there is, okay, we use there is in singular. Like there is a chair, and we use the are when we're speaking about more or two things. Like example, there are two doors, there are two cars, there are two beds, there is a chair, estamos hablando que hay una silla, o there is a person, hay una persona, o there are people, ahí hay personas, we use there are, okay? Are you looking at your workbook? ¿Están viendo la cómo se utiliza there is there are in your model?
There are, yes, teacher.
There are and there is, okay, in the page 22 and in page 23. In the page 23, you have a small practice. There, you're going to put is there is or there are. Example, we have the first pictures. We have some books and we have an apple. Okay, what demonstrative form we use? There is or there are? You have five books.
There is.
We have five books. There are. Why are? Because are is plural. And is singular. So we use there are and we use there is. There is singular and there are is plural. Utilizamos there are cuando estamos hablando de más de dos cosas. And there is, we use it when we speak it only one thing. Cuando estamos hablando de una sola cosa. Okay, we clear?
Are is singular.
Plural.
Plural. Is singular.
Is singular. Okay, we have the next picture. We have a notebook. Okay, and if sentence say, there is or there are a notebook. In the page 23. There en la página 23 estamos.
There is.
There is a notebook.
There is.
But we have three things. We have a notebook, we have a pencil, and we have a pen. It's plural or singular? There are. There are notebook, pencil, and pen. Okay, this is there are because it's plural. We have three types of things. Tenemos tres diferentes cosas. Okay? We have rules, ruler. There is or there are?
There is
a ruler. Yes, because we have only one ruler. Tenemos una regla. So it's singular. So we use there is. And we have two chairs in the classroom. Singular or plural?
There are. That's the singular.
There are two chairs in the classroom. So to make you apply there is and there are, remember that there is singular and there are is plural. There is when we speak about one thing and there are when we speak about more or two things. Cuando hablamos de más de una cosa utilizamos is. Y cuando hablamos de there are es cuando hablamos que tenemos más de dos cosas. Okay, there we see in the practice of the model. Lo vemos aquí en la práctica del módulo. ¿Cómo podemos identificar when we use there is and when we can use there are? Okay, are we clear?
No.
¿Estamos claros hasta aquí?
En la electrónica, Hong Kong. Control, me estás hablando.
Ajá. You have any questions?
No, teacher.
Okay. The class before, we see the simple past. En la clase anterior vimos lo que era el simple past. In the page number 20, en la página 20, we see the rules adding ed and adding eed, agregando ed, d, y ed. Okay, remember, depend of the ending of the regular verbs. De acuerdo a la terminación del verbo, ustedes van a aplicar la regla del simple past tense. También les expliqué que cuando el verbo empieza con una vocal y un consonante, ¿qué pasa? What happened? When we have a vowel and a consonant.
Se dobla el consonante.
Se dobla la consonante.
We double the consonant plus y agregamos el simple past ed or es or d. Remember that. You have to add that clear. Here in the page number 20, you have the rules. En la página 20, tienen las reglas, ¿verdad? La regla de cómo utilizar el simple past. tienen las reglas para que puedan aplicarla. In this page, number 20, we have some practice that you can develop applying the rules, the irregular verb in the simple past. Ahí tenemos, ¿verdad? Reglas que podemos aplicarles a los verbos irregulares en la oración. Remember, we have the sentences in present. La tenemos en presente and we want to apply it in past. Lo vamos a aplicar en pasado. So, in this page, you have the rules. Tienen las reglas. ¿Cómo podemos aplicarlas? ¿Ok? ¿Estamos claros? Are we clear?
I'm clear, teacher.
Okay. Remember, you can see in the page number 20, the rule of the simple past tense. We see two topics today. Vimos dos temas hoy. We see the simple past tense, and we see how we apply the rules, and we see the next part that there is and there are. There is a singular, and there are is plural. And we have some pictures that you can identify when it's plural and when it's singular. Aquí en las imágenes, ustedes pueden ver si es plural o si es singular. So you can use there is or we can use there are. In the platform, en la plataforma, ustedes pueden encontrar, ahí van a encontrar unas prácticas que les dejé, lo que son virtuales. Ana, exercise, un ejercicio les dejé ahí mismo en donde hice trabajo. I leave you a exercise. The exercise is there is, there are. And we have assignments of the simple past applying the rules in the verb. Ahí ustedes van a aplicar en las oraciones el simple pasado. ¿Ok? Ok, we clear till here. ¿Estamos claritos hasta aquí? We have any questions?
No, teacher, I understand.
No questions. The rest of the group, I see you too silent today. Lo veo muy calladito hoy. What happened? You have any questions?
No questions, teacher. I understand.
Okay.
Teacher, wait question.
Okay, wait a moment. When to stop the taping to make you can ask me any question you have about the class. Okay. So remember, we give two topics today. We give the simple past tense, we apply the rules, and we give the there is and there are to locate things, para localizar cosas. Okay, wait a moment. So remember, virtual, you have some assignment in the platform, modular, you have to make your practice in the module. And wait a moment.